continued in the graphic design order. If somebody says to you they're a graphic designer, I'm a typographer, I draw, I work with images, photography, illustration, print, but I bring things together. So I'm an art director. I spent 50 years as a creative director or art director. And just because I don't have a beret and a smock and my clothes in a certain way, no, that's me, an artist, but there are many different kinds of art. Okay? So I am a commercial artist. I took the same schooling as the man who has a smock. Same schooling as the man who has a beret, but I wanted to make some money. And the pages didn't seem to make any money. They're all, as soon as they graduated, they're all just hanging out around the art college outside the front. We had to get to London, get a job, get working, and start earning money, so that was the key. So I worked in Toronto for years and years and years and years, 50 years. I ran my own company, and I had some wonderful, wonderful clients. And I did many things for these people. But most of the things I did was periodicals, publications. So if you went to a Stratford, I was laid on your lap in Stratford. If you went to a hockey game, I was rolled up, ready to. So you've known me for years. If you had a weekend newspaper, I was in the weekend newspaper. I was thinking that they're shadowing. The list of publications that I've designed, redesigned, and worked on over that 50-year period was immense. Mr. Magazine, they called me. And it didn't stop me thinking, I want to paint. So throughout this period, I'm running a studio, running young designers, and working for many different companies. I had the best oil company. Turning page. And that's what I was.